Hi everyone, Bernard here on behalf of MovieGameNostalgia.com. Hope you're all well. This is a little information vlog on what's out in the world at the moment. So these are all available from the 20th of April 2020. Please, if you're new to the channel, push the old subscribe button there, push the bell notifications so you know when these little movie vlogs and information vlogs and reviews, etc. are coming out. Please, thumbs up is always in there. It's always nice to get views, but it's lovely to get thumbs ups as well. So please, do that for me. Right, we've got four films this week and two box sets, and the four films will start with the biggie of the week, really. Star Wars: The Rise of Skywalker, obviously now out to buy. 12A, $9.99 DVD, $14.99 Blu-ray, $19.99 3D, and $24.99 on 4K, which is not a bad price. 2 hours 22 minutes, an action adventure fantasy, of course, the epic space opera film, produced, co-written and directed by J.J. Abrams, the third installment of the Star Wars sequel trilogy following The Force Awakens 2015 and The Last Jedi 2017. And this is the final episode of the 9-part Skywalker saga. Produced by Lucasfilm and Abrams production company, Bad Robot Productions, was distributed by Walt Disney Studios Motion Pictures. Of course, we have an ensemble cast, including Carrie Fisher, who sadly is no longer with us, but obviously footage was put together from previous obviously incarnations, etc. So that's Carrie Fisher, wonderful, wonderful actress. It's nice to see her, if only on celluloid, obviously. Mark Hamill, Adam Driver, Daisy Ridley, John Boyega, Oscar Isaac, Anthony Daniels, Kelly Marie Tran, Naomi Aki, Dom Hill Gleeson, Richard E. Grant, Lupita Nyong'o, Kerry Russell, Juno Suatama, Ian McDiarmid, and Billy Dee Williams. What's it about? Well, the surviving members of the Resistance face the First Order once again, and the legendary conflict between the Jedi and the Sith reaches its peak, bringing the Skywalker saga to its end. Any good? Well, review aggregator Rotten Tomatoes reported an approval rating of 52% based on 481 reviews, with an average rating of just over 6 out of 10, which is okay. The website's critics' consensus read, "The Rise of Skywalker suffers from a frustrating lack of imagination, but concludes this beloved saga with fan-focused devotion." And on Metacritic, the Metascore rating, the film has a weighted average of 5.3 out of 10. Again, not great, based on 61 critics who scored it anywhere between 3.8 and 7.5, so not massive scores. New York Post Johnny Oleksinski gave it 7.5 out of 10. And he wrote, "Although director J.J. Abrams tries his darndest to finish the job, conjuring up nostalgia like a TV medium, Rise doesn't feel like the last chapter of the biggest American movie franchise. It's just another well-made Star Wars flick." And Slap Magazine didn't like it very much. They were the most critical at only 3.8 out of 10. "The film, hyper-aware of the shadow cast by the franchise's history, struggles to both honour and redeem the past before everything comes to a close." It's got an overall internet movie database, Joe Public rating of 6.7 out of 10. Me, yeah, I'm probably a 6. It wasn't anything special. So anyway, that's Star Wars Rise of Skywalker. Yeah, I mean, it just didn't, you know, it finished the series, didn't it? So it had to come to an end, and okay, I've seen worse, put it that way. And the next one we're going to look at, Black Christmas, a 15 rating, obviously, if you want that Christmas feeling, snow on the ground, etc. It's an hour and 32 minutes, horror mystery thriller. It's a slasher film directed by Sophia Takal and written by Takal and April Wolf. It's part of the Black Christmas series. He should have stopped at the first one, though, unfortunately. It is the loose second remake of the 1974 Canadian film Black Christmas, which was a passable slasher film. After the 2006 film, which we won't talk about here, and follows a group of sorority girls at Hawthorne College as they are preyed upon by an unknown stalker. Stars Imogen Poots, Elise Shannon, Lily Donahue, Brittany O'Grady, Caleb Eberhardt, and Carrie Elwes. Any good? Well, I wouldn't be surprised if we see another one, because it cost $5 million to make and they took back almost $90 million at the box office. That's before out to buy and home rentals, etc. So that's pretty good. although the film, Rotten Tomatoes gave the film an approval rating of 38% based on 100 reviews, with an average rating of 4.4 out of 10. Again, not great. The site's critical consensus reads, "Better than the 2006 remake." Be very hard to be worse. yet not as sharp as the original. Absolutely not. The Black Christmas stabs at timely feminist themes, but mostly hits on familiar pulp. The Metascore rating assigned its awaited average of 4.9 out of 10 based on just 25 critics' reviews. And it scored anywhere between 2 and an incredible 8.6 out of 10. The Guardian Benjamin Lee gave it 2 out of 10 and wrote, "It's an unweirdly and messy thing, drearily directed and boringly written, taking its agenda seriously yet not providing a robust enough framework to surround it." IGN gave it 8.6 out of 10. "Blended brilliantly, this remake of Black Christmas makes of a holiday horror that's a tantalising and terrifying treat." Probably the checks in the pulse from the film producers, I think, to IGN. Internet Movie Database, overall rating, Joe Public, You and Me, 3.2 out of 10. My rating, I fell asleep and I don't really particularly want to go back and watch it again. Villain is the next one out. Villain, an 18 rating, a British one, £7 on DVD, an hour and 37 minutes. Please, I've done a fuller review on this, so please check the links below. It stars Craig Fairbrass, Robert Glenister, Nicholas Arran, director Philip Barantini. It's a crime drama, British crime drama thriller. It's about Eddie Franks, who is a former criminal, attempts to help his family by reconnecting with his daughter and clearing his brother's debt. Despite his efforts, he is drawn back into a criminal way of life with devastating consequences. Internet Movie Database rating, he's got 6.7 out of 10, so it's done quite well. And there's a lot of pros about it. There's not much negativity about the film with the people who've left reviews. So please check my thoughts on the film in the links below and please have a watch of that. It's only a 5 or 6 minute vlog or something like that. But you'll get a taste of what Villain is like, but that's out to buy from the 20th of April. And the next one, I'm going to look at another British one that's caused a bit of controversy already here in the UK. It's a film called Blue Story, a 15 rating, £9.99 on DVD, an hour and 31 minutes. It's a crime drama and stars Stephen Odubola, Michael Ward and Callie Best. And it's directed by Ratman. Obviously, if you've got a YouTube presence, so if you're in, it's not someone I'm familiar with, but I'm not really demographic, am I, for this sort of thing. Feature adaptation and directorial debut of Ratman's YouTube series. Blue Story is a tragic tale of best friends Marco and Timmy, who from different areas of London, Peckham and Deptford, find themselves becoming enemies in a violent and insidious postcode war. Blue Story is based around events of Ratman's own personal experiences growing up in Deptford in the London Borough of Lewisham and being sent to school in Peckham in the London Borough of Southwark, thereby crossing gang-affiliated borders. The film depicts real-life gangs, the Peckham Boys and the Ghetto Boys. It's a little bit of a worrying background on the cinema release. On the 23rd of November 2019, it was reported that during a screening of Blue Story at Star City, a cinema complex in Birmingham, England, police were attacked by a group armed with machetes. Police arrested 5 teenagers. Families at the complex were also watching Frozen 2 at the time when the disorder broke out, sparking an evacuation of the complex, with police stating up to 100 teenagers were involved in major disorder. I mean, these guys actually go and watch the film, or does he just stand outside and cause trouble? A spokesperson for West Midlands Police stated that dozens of officers were sent to the complex after a 999 call just after 5:30 p.m. reporting a group of youths with machetes. Two machetes were seized during the trouble, which saw pockets of fighting and 7 police officers left with minor injuries as they dealt with the crowds in and around the cinema. On the 24th of November 2019, West Midlands Police reported that 6 teenagers had been added to those arrested, which included a female aged just 13, a male and female both aged 14, and a 19-year-old man. Following the disorder at Star City, the View Cinemas, the View chain of cinemas, cancelled all screenings of Blue Story. A statement from View said that during the first 24 hours of the film, more than 25 significant incidents were reported and escalated to senior management in 16 separate cinemas around the country. Cinema chain Showcase subsequently also ceased showing the film, but the Odeon and Cineworlds chains continued to screen it. The ban by Showcase and View was labelled as racist by some people on social media, with Showcase later reversing their decision. The film's director, Ratman, also questioned the reasons behind the ban. Well, perhaps you use running around with machetes when there's children around is one reason, Ratman. I don't know who you are, but perhaps that's one reason for the ban. View also said they would restart showings with increased security. It's also noted that most of this cast is starring the Netflix series Top Boy, which again I've not really watched, and again I'm not really in the demographic for that. But please check out my views on this anyway a bit later in the review. Links are below. Is it any good? Well, away from the troubles, it actually only cost $1.3 million to make, but it actually made back almost $5 million, so it's done pretty well for a low budget effort. On the review aggregator Rotten Tomatoes, the film has an approval rating of 92%. This is only based on 12 reviews with an average rating of 7 out of 10, which is still quite high. Mike McCahill of The Guardian gave the film 3 out of 5 and called it an assured and capably performed morality play. The BBC films themselves say the film powerfully depicts the futility of gang violence, so perhaps there is a point and something to be made in this. Internet Movie Database is just 5.5 out of 10, which is a little bit below watchable, isn't it? The pros, people say, this is what people said about the film, glad I saw it, more than just violence and knives, a good film, gritty, well-made British gang culture movie, great movie, better than expected. Some of the cons, though: trash, badly executed, good try but poor, too many dumb characters, disappointing, a bit dull, and could do with subtitles. Please check out my review and see what I thought about the Blue Story anyway. And the box sets, I've got Mr. Robot. I mean, I was quite impressed with season 4. I thought it was a big improvement on season 3. 13 episodes, 642 minutes, $14.99 on DVD, $17.99 on Blu-ray. Of course, we'll pick up where the third season finale left off, delving into the pros and cons of Elliot hitting send on the email that could reverse 5-9. If you're anything like me, I always watch the last episode of the preceding season just to familiarise myself, because I do forget what's happened. So if you're anything like me, do that and then buy the film and watch the rest of it. Any good? Well, the episodes are rating anywhere between 8.5 and 9.9, which I totally agree with that. I did really enjoy this season of Mr. Robot. So that's season 4 is now out to buy. And finally, a British drama coming back for a third time. This is series 3, $18.99 on DVD, Good Karma Hospital. 7 episodes, 270 minutes. And it's in series 3, British expat Dr. Ruby Walker has left the Good Karma Hospital to practice as a GP near a family in rural India. But when a medical crisis forces her return, Ruby must make peace with the hospital's intimidating head, Dr. Lydia Fonseca. And there's plenty more where that came off. Any good? Well, the episodes are getting an okay 6.9 to 7.4. I do like Good Karma Hospital. It's not edge of the seat stuff. But if you're a fan of the format and you're a fan of Good Karma Hospital season series 1 and 2, you're just going to get more of the same. So that's Good Karma Hospital season 3 now out to buy, along with Mr. Robot and the movies Star Wars, Rise of Skywalker, Villain, Blue Story and Black Christmas. So anyway, thanks for watching this. Hope you enjoyed that. Please let me know in the comments if you get to watch any of these or buy any of these, and let me know your thoughts on the films, and please do check out my more in-depth reviews on Villain, I was gonna say Black Christmas, and I won't be doing a review on that, on Villain and Blue Story as well, which is an interesting review anyway, to say the least. So please, thanks for watching. Please follow me on Twitter for the latest movie, TV, drama news. Two accounts, you can follow either, they're both linked anyway, at Charles Deneen's, Deneen spelled D-I-N-N-N, or at Nostalgia_movie. And I'm on Facebook at Bernard Deneen, with links to moviegamenostalgia.com, my little website for old rare DVDs, movie posters from the 90s and 2000s, and some board games. So if you ever go on there, have a quick look at moviegamenostalgia.com. It would be very, very much appreciated. Anyway, thanks for watching today. What are you going to do the rest of the day? Have a great one. Look after yourselves. Look after your friends. Look after your family. Let's all look after each other. This is Bernard saying goodbye till the next time. Bye-bye. Thanks for watching.